What's up, everybody? I'm Katie Tizuki, and this week I'm in Wanaka at the Board House. Here, I'm going to talk to you about boards, boots, and bindings, and everything you need to know about getting some great gear for the 2013 season. All right, so first we're going to talk about snowboards. And with snowboards, there's two things to look at. The first one is the length, and the second one is the shape. Let's start this party off with talking about length. The thing that you need to know about length is that you want your snowboard coming somewhere between your chin and your nose. Think of it this way. If you want to jump around the park and do very maneuverable things, then you want it in about your chin. If you want to hit some mad pal lines and take some deep snow, then you probably want it around your nose. The next thing you need to know about buying your board are the different shapes. Now, if you put boards on a spectrum, on one end of the spectrum would be rocker, and on the other end of the spectrum would be camber. One way to know if you're riding a rocker board is that when you put it flat on the ground, it's going to be up at the tip and the tail. Rocker boards are going to be great in the powder, they're going to be forgiving for beginners, and they'll be a boatload of fun. The other shape is a camber board. The way how you're going to know it's a camber board is that it's going to be center high off of the ground. The more the camber, the higher it's going to be. Camber boards are great for loading up your board, for features like pipe and jump, so that your board will be sprung right up into the air with you. When choosing a binding, you want to make sure that you are comfortable. You want to make sure that your boot is going to be able to fit really nice into this binding, because this is what's going to connect you to your board, to your fun. When you're choosing your boots, you need to keep this in mind. This is an item that you might have for about four seasons, whereas a board and bindings you might only have for two. So make sure that you go into a store, try them on, and make sure there's no pressure points. Don't be afraid to spend a little bit more money on this item. Now let's talk about your main options of where you're going to get your gear. The first one is your local board shop. The second one is a big superstore. Your local board shop will be carrying very core brands, and they'll have a great, knowledgeable staff. Whereas the superstore will have a wider selection and a little bit of discount boards to fit your budget. All right, everybody, it's time for a recap. We got boards, we got their length and their shape. We got bindings and their comfort and fit to your boots. We got boots and how they fit to your feet and not being scared to spend a little bit more money. And we got the two different places of where we might get our gear. So make sure you come back next week. We're going to be talking about outerwear. And don't forget, have a great ride.